This will be the apps portion for the Amazon Echo Cube. For starters, I will say the Echo Cube does not seem to like capture cards, which is why we're doing this old school with the remote and camera pointed at the TV. Sorry about that. It is what it is. So starting off, when we first land on our Amazon page here, you're going to notice something. If you have any other Amazon Fire Stick related products, this menu system is going to look very similar. And that's because, well, in essence, your Echo Cube has the Amazon Fire Smarts built right into it. So we're going to land on the home page, which is where we are. It's going to have this banner image right here, letting you know, hey, these are things that are going on. You can cycle through them. And this is an ad that just will never go away. Right here, we have our recent. So right now you can see my recent app is actually Netflix. And down here we have all of my apps. So Netflix, Prime, all of these things. We've got our sponsor right here. This is around the Halloween holiday. So they are heavily promoting Disney Plus and the new Hocus Pocus movie. Here we have Prime Originals, lots of things to look at. Prime Movies, Prime Comedy, Prime Action. You get the idea. They're really pushing the Prime stuff. And then here we have Netflix Recommends. This is based on whoever was last watching Netflix. So in my case, it was me. So it's recommending Cobra Kai as the first thing, since that is actually what I was watching. Now you have On Now. This is actually going to be a way to pull in live feeds. So whatever applications you have on here that are live, such as Pluto, Freevee, things like that, it will pull and aggregate those all in one place. And here we have To Be Recommends, Recommended by Your Apps, Sponsored Apps. Really, it's aggregating all of these sources and putting them in one place so that you can see them. Here we got Sponsored for the Week, Prime, Recommended Apps, and I'm going all the way to the bottom of this because I want to show you, once I get to the bottom, if I select the back arrow on my remote, it actually brings me all the way up to the top of the menu, which is what I prefer in a system like this. Now, because this is an Amazon Echo device, you can either hold down the blue Amazon Alexa portion of your remote, or you can tell the Echo Cube to launch any channel. So in this case, I could say, Alexa, open Netflix. So see, I didn't do it fast enough. Oh. There you can see it actually opened up Netflix for me. And I could do that with any of the applications that are on here. Coming back up to our menu, that was our home. If we select over to the left, this is going to be our search function. We can press and hold the voice option on our remote, which is our blue Alexa button, and search for Mark Hamill. And then it's gonna bring up anything that Mark Hamill is in. Gonna go back, and it will do similar if you happen to type it out. We're not going to type it out because that's not good television. Coming across, we have live. This is going to be, again, an aggregate of all of your live services. Coming down, you've got an app, you have an ad, then you actually get your featured live apps, and you could cycle through these. These are not necessarily ones that I have on my system, but ones that it thinks I would want. Here we have another sponsored ad, and then we move through live sports, breaking news, Pluto TV, which I do have, Tubi, which I have, and these are other channels that you can get that are live, or apps that you can put on here. Add Prime Video, and then you've got options specific to live TV. So you've got your channel guide, you have your favorites, if you have any favorites, and that's across all of your live TV options. Parental controls as they apply to just live TV, and then settings. So I'm skipping a lot of these because we're going to talk about those when we actually get to the settings portion, but here is what the live TV guide looks like. So you can kind of come through here and it gives you a synopsis, and over in the corner, it shows you a little bit about what it is. I'm gonna select back, and back one more time brings me back up to the top, which again, I really appreciate. Your videos, this is going to be Prime specific. So this is anything on Amazon that you happen to watch or bookmark. Right here, my wife and I went down a rabbit hole of finding really bad movies to watch. And then you have things like Vox Machina mixed in here, but this is all the stuff that we were looking at. Here we have video library. This is shared across my Movies Anywhere selection because none of these I actually have through Amazon. So this section is showing because of Movies Anywhere. Here we have another sponsored, but coming down, Prime Movies again, Prime Originals, Netflix recommended. This page looks very similar to our homepage, but this is just our videos. Moving on, we have free. So this is going to be free for you. You have things like, here's a individual show that is free, and you can come across and look through all the free shows, or you can come down and look at your free apps on Fire TV. And then Pluto recommends, again, because I have that channel, popular free movies, Tubi recommends, which is another channel that I have on here, trending free TV shows, Free V recently added, and then again, coming all the way through, there's lots of segregated spaces that you can go through to see, hey, what can I watch for free? Coming across, movies, similarly, we always have this ad right there, which we go past. Prime movies you'll like, Prime Movie Originals, sponsor. Things to rent, Freevee, Prime Video Cinema, Prime Member Deals. So these aren't free, but you can rent them for cheap. I like how they aggregate things together to make finding things easier, but sometimes it's over-aggregated and it feels like you have to hunt and pick because some things will show up on this screen and this screen. It's a mixed bag. Coming across, TV shows. Well, as you might imagine, here we have all of our Amazon-related TV shows. We have Prime Comedy. So again, featuring our Amazon stuff first. Sponsor, Prime Amazon Original, Freevee Original, Prime Kids, Prime Science Fiction, Prime, you get the idea. Apps, this is where you can add extra applications to your Amazon Fire Cube. Now you can see spotlighted here, I have Pluto TV, which is already on my Amazon Cube, so I have an open button there. But if I were to come over to something like Travel Go, which isn't yet on here, I will have the option to download it. But it also shows at the bottom here, featured recently on this app. So featured in this app, giving you an idea, hey, these are the things that you can watch, trailers and screenshot. Customers also got the apps of these things, and then customer ratings, information, and so forth. And that's gonna be for every app. And again, it's gonna break it down and bundle it into these groupings. So entertainment, sports, no cable required, Alexa enabled, which means you can use your voice and Alexa to control things like volume up, skip, turn off. That is one thing I really like about the Cube. If you give a command to raise the volume on this screen, you'll notice a blue line pops up on the bottom. Alexa, mute. So right there, my soundbar has been muted all through that, the Cube. I can also say, Alexa, turn off TV. Alexa, turn on TV. So not only can you use your voice to control things like that, you would be able to say pause or skip ahead, rewind X percent, and it will do that. So that's kind of cool. Back up to the top, we come over to our last screen, which is our settings, and then selecting down on the remote brings us into them. Here we have our notifications. I don't currently have any notifications, but if I select my hamburger button in the corner, I can set up settings within the notifications. So I can have do not interrupt, which will hide any notifications while I'm watching something. And then I have options to block or unblock notifications from a specific app. Coming back, we have our networking options. So right now I am actually connected to my IoT network wirelessly, but if I wanted to, I can have the Ethernet plugged in or I could select another Wi-Fi connection to attach to. Moving on, display and sounds. Here we have screensaver options. So I have current screensaver, which is Amazon collections. I can do daily memories, your photos, recent photos, photo booth, and then it will actually break it down into specific albums that I have on Amazon Photos. So it does integrate into that. Here I have display, selecting that. I have video resolution, auto 1080, 720, match original frame rate, on or off. So you, depending on how adept you are with TV options, you can either choose not to match the frame rate of the original video and override that with other areas, or you can turn on match and let the Echo Cube take care of it for you. Color depth, you have 8-bit, 10-bit, or 12-bit. Color format, auto, RGB, or YCBCR. Don't know what that is? Leave it on auto. Calibrate display, which will let you make sure that you're utilizing as much screen real estate as possible. And then dynamic range settings, HDR always, or adaptive. That's display. Now we're going to go to audio. Navigation sound on or off. That's gonna be the clicking slash badoop badoops that you'd be hearing. Surround sound, best available, stereo, always Dolby Digital Plus or always Dolby Digital. Back, advanced audio, volume leveling, as you might imagine, kind of help those explosions quiet down and raise the people's voices while they're talking. And then dialogue enhancer, do you just want people's voices to be enhanced? That's what you would choose for that. And then AV sync tuning. If you're experiencing issues with your audio and video syncing up, this is what you would select. Enable display mirroring. Well, realistically, if I wanted to mirror something from a Fire tablet, that's where I would do. HDMI CEC device control, which would allow your cube to send information via HDMI instead of IR, which it currently is doing as we speak. Selecting back and over, we have our applications. We have Amazon Photos, which if you have photos, will let you look through your photos. You've got your Silk browser. This is the same browser that the Kindle uses. So this is a very lightweight browser that you can utilize with the cube on your TV. Game Circle. This will allow you to control privacy within your game. Whisper Sync for game, for me, it's on currently because that's how it comes default. App Store. Do we want automatic updates for our apps? Yes or no? External market links, ask before opening is what's currently set, but you can say don't open or others. In-app purchases, well, you can have that on or off. Manage my subscriptions, on or off. Notifications, on or off, and hide cloud apps. So if something has been offloaded from your device and is relegated to the cloud, if you have this on, you'll see it kind of grayed out and it will let you know that it's in the cloud. But I have that currently turned off because I have plenty of space on my cube. And then you have manage installed applications. And here you could see I have 10 gigs of pretty much 12 gigs available. And there's no external USB, but I can select manage applications. And if I wanted to remove or see specific information about an app, this is where I would come. Next, we have equipment control. Equipment control, automatic video and music. Well, you could turn that off or by request. I have it on automatic. Manage equipment. You can add equipment here, such as live TV, game console, blah, 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 TV. And this will let you determine volume increase based on button push or what you ask for. Increments at a time currently is set for 5. Fast forward or rewind will allow you to plus or minus the volume. And then your hamburger button sets the default. Infrared options, adjust TV IR. We're not going to do that because it's already set up. Power controls, well, this is if your TV does not respond to the IR control, it will delay for 16 seconds before trying again. Power command toggles on the TV. Power command repetition, this will manage how many times the IR signal is sent when you're trying to do something. Configure projector, if you had one. Input switching, so if you want to be able to adjust your input via the cube or the remote that comes with it. And then change TV. Soundbar, if you have it, you've got pretty much the same thing that we had with the TV controls right there. Fire Cube, input, sound output. Again, if you have all the cableage for this, you can mess with it there. Advanced settings, volume control devices. So I have it to TV or soundbar. Right now I have it on the soundbar because that's where my TV sound actually comes through. Volume and power buttons, Fire Remote or Fire Cube. So you could pick which one you'd like. Power timing, power input, and home button. There's a lot of options, there's a lot of nuances from this menu. And then you have the option to set up your equipment again. I'm not gonna do that because like I said, I already set up my equipment. I'm not doing that again. Here we have live TV. So we've got favorite channels, manage channels, parental controls, and then the sync source. So parental controls, if I come in here, they're currently off, but I can turn this on, and then I would set a pin code that I would be able to input in order to turn on and off the parental controls. Once I do that, I'll have the ability to limit specific channels and age ratings for content. And then here are the 95 channels, but this is all based on Tubi and Pluto. So it's pulling those all together and displaying them as one, which is one really good thing about the Amazon Fire interface, since it pulls in all of that information into one section with your live TV. And then favorite channels would be listed there if I had any. Moving over, we have our controls and Bluetooth, Amazon Fire Remote, Amazon Fire TV Remote. You can see type, battery is okay, and then version 7. And then a serial number which is blocked off. I can add a new remote if I want. Game controllers, you're gonna have similar. Mobile device, again, similar. And other Bluetooth devices, similar if you wanted to add a mouse or a keyboard. Alexa options, selecting this. Well, we have the Alexa app, things to try, favor this device. So that means if you have other devices, this will be the one that listens more often. Communication, configure communication with this device. Wake word, you could change it. If you didn't know, you've got Alexa, Amazon, computer, and Echo, which are different ways that you could wake up all of your Alexa devices. Moving on, we have preferences. So here's another place where you can get into the parental controls. Privacy settings, probably should go through here. Device usage data, well, you can see by default that's on, but you could turn it off if you wanted to. Collect app usage data, same thing, on or off. Interspace ads, I turned that off as soon as I got here because I don't want that. Data monitoring. Notification settings. Again, this is another place that we can get to it. You're gonna notice a lot of redundancies within the user interface. Featured content, allow videos to autoplay, and allow audio to autoplay. So when I was going through those ad sections and you started hearing and seeing the little preview play, that's where you can control that from. Current location, just blur it out, but that's where you're currently located. Time zone, just like it sounds. Language, you have lots of choices right there. Metric units, so are you Imperial or not? Moving on, we have My Fire TV. We have About. We've got developer options, legal, sleep, if you want to set your device to sleep. You can restart your device from here, and then you also have the ability to factory reset the device. Accessibility options, you've got closed captioning, on or off. If you turn them on, notice that you get extra options with a preview on the right. So you've got text, background color, window background, use Amazon Web Services settings, and then reset to default. You'll notice in the corner before I had something saying that I had an update to some of my applications. Voice viewer, this will be spoken feedback. So if I press or hover over a particular option, I will get audio feedback. Here we have our text banner, screen magnifier, high contrast on and off, and then audio description. So this is again, I'm on this app is, I'm on this, press plus, that's what that is. But lots of accessibility options, which is appreciated. Help, as it might sound, helpful videos, quick tips, contact us, or feedback. My account, well, it's gonna have your personal information at the top, but aside from that, you have the ability to sync your content, so that's gonna be able to sync your content across multiple Amazon devices if you have them. And then Prime Video, if you have any subscriptions, this is where you can kind of keep track of all of that in one place. And that was our account, and I'm gonna hit home because that covers all the windows that we have on the Fire Cube for the Fire TV portion. But last thing, notice right here, settings, there's a little notification icon right here. Now there's actually something there. If I select that, well, here we go. Amazon Music has 4 updates available. So if I select that, I have 4 channels that have updates available. I can select update like this, and you'll see right there underneath, that is an update in progress. And once that is done, it will move on to the next one. Lower right-hand corner there, it was showing me I made an update to that. This one's getting updated, and now I just have 2 left. But coming back to our main screen here, that is everything that you need to know about the navigation and settings for the Fire TV portion of the Amazon Fire Cube.